confusion. So what this class is going to look like is we're going to focus on lower body and cardio when we're on the step, and then we're going to focus on upper body when we're off of the step, and we'll finish with a little bit of core at the very end. You do not need a step for this class, so everything I do on the step can just be done on the floor. So keep that in mind. Also, if you have a set of stairs, you could do some of these moves on the bottom row of your stairs if you wanted to have that extra level for cardio. Otherwise, just do it on the floor. You're still going to get a great workout in. It's just going to be without that little elevation that you'll get with the step. So if you have a step, pull it out. You'll also need a medium set of dumbbells for today. All right, so grab that and we're gonna get started with our warm up. All right, step aside to side here. Be soft. We have that step, we're right behind it.
Pull.
Good. Pull. Use that core. Pull. meters. Three knees. Three, two, one. Switch it. Good. Three, two, one. Switch it. Three, two, one. Woo! Three, two, one. Keep it up. Pull that knee up towards the chest. Nice and strong. Engage that core. Good. Three, two, one. Switch it. Three, two, one. Keep it going. Six more. Two, one. Five more. Three, two, one. Last four. Three more. Keep it going. Two, one. Last two. Three, two, one. Last one. Three, two, one. March it out. Come to the side of your step. One foot on, one foot off. Squat to twist. Three, two, one, let's go. Drop, twist, drop, twist, drop, twist, drop, twist. We can do this on the floor. Drop, twist, drop, twist. Get that elbow to the knee. Exhale, twist, drop, twist, drop, twist, drop, twist. Keep it up. Drop, twist. Six more. Six. Good. Five. Four, three, two, one. Lift the knee. Lift, lift, lift. Take it back. Take it up. Lift, lift, lift. Good. There we go. Outer knee, inner knee, outer. L step. Great job. Up. Keeping on. Lift, lift, lift. Woo. Lift, lift, lift. Good. Keep it up. Lift. Great job, guys. Up, up, up. Give me a few more. Lift, lift, lift. We're going to end up on that other side. We got squats or twists. Six more. Six. Up, up. Five more. Five. Engage that core. Four. Three more. Three. Get ready for that squat to twist. Come it up. Last one here. Three, two, one. Squat twist. Drop. Twist. Drop. Twist. Good. Drop. Twist. Woo-hoo! Keep it going. Drop. Twist. Drop. Twist. Drop. Drop and twist. 10 more here. Remember, we can do this on the floor. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. March it out. V step. Three, two, one. Take it up. Up, up. Good. Nice and wide on the way up. Together on the way down. Up, up. Good. Keep it here. Then we're on the floor. Your chest. Big step out. Back in. Out, up, and in. Out, up. In, in. Good. Keep it up. We're moving, we're working. Woo! Eight. Seven. We're going to add on two jacks at the bottom. Four. Three. Two. Get ready. Two jacks. Here we go. Two. One. One. Up. Two. One. Two, one, modify on that jack. Two, one, take it up, 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 down, down. Two, and one, up, up, up. Two, one, up, up. Two, one, woo. Keep it going. That heart rate should be up. We should be sweating a little bit. Come on, up, up, reset. Two, one, up, up. Two, one, up, up, come on. Remember those modifications. We're moving. Six, five more. Five. Woo! Up. Four. Three more. Three. Up. Last two. Last one. Up, up. uplift.
Three.
or the front part of our shoulder, will be chest. Good. Out. Squeeze. Out. Squeeze. 8, 7, and 6, 5. Give me 4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax. Bring those arms up. Arnold press. Palms are in. Then rotate out. Palms forward. Press at the top. Reset. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Out. Push. Down. In. Out. Vertical. We're going to just Making it a little bit smaller. Or you can be on the floor. Tap. need it. Okay guys, so we're grabbing our weights. We're gonna focus on upper body again. Finish with a little bit of core, all right? I want you to hinge over, bend the hips, knees soft, palms in, grab our squat. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Squeeze.
Six, squeeze in. Five, hit the big hook. Four.
4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax. Keep one of those weights. Drop the other to the side. Toes up, toe touch. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Exhale, reach. Exhale, reach. Feel free to put one hand behind the head. Exhale up. Reach. 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 Good. Exhale.
Hug those knees in, rock yourself side to side a little bit.
Slowly roll on up, coming into a seated position. V out the legs. Take an inhale up and reach down towards one of your legs. Doesn't matter which one, we will hit them both. So we're trying to stretch out the backs of our leg here. So your hamstring, your calves, if you can pull back slightly on your toes, that's great. Stretch out those calves a little bit. Good, take an inhale up. Exhale, forward fold, other leg. And even if you can't do any like of the jumping that we did, that wasn't super high impact, but there was a lot of movement in it. So if you're in a situation at home where you can't really jump around, I hope that kind of the modifications of the lower impact helps give you an option. I put my step on my mat. I forgot to say that in the beginning of class, but that's a good way to help absorb some of the jumping. Let's go and come into butterfly. So I like to have my mat out for that reason, and any plyometric work I do or jumping, I like to be on this mat. One day I would like to invest in one of those bigger mats I've seen people have. I think they're like one of the famous or popular brands is Gorilla mats. If anybody has one and loves it, let me know. Because they're just really big for a lot of different activities that you can do on them. Let's go ahead and come into a comfortable seated position. Bring one arm back behind the head. Try to keep your chin off your chest if you can, stretching out your tricep, upper back a little bit, shoulder. I've also seen those mats that you can buy on Amazon that like you interlock, and so you can buy as many as you need, how much square footage you need. I kind of like that too, but I'm a little afraid of like a tripping hazard if it like kind of comes unlocked or not locked in together. The switch, you might trip on that. So I don't know. I think like a fully just big mat would be the best option. And my basement is concrete, and so jumping is a little bit tough on that. Good, let's go ahead and switch. There's no bounce. Let's go ahead and release those fingers. Press away, drop the chin, rounding out the shoulders. Good, switch, interlace the fingers behind you, open up the chest, drop the shoulders down, look up towards the ceiling. Make sure you drink plenty of water after that workout. Good, you may not be drinking as much water as you used to, or maybe you're drinking more, just kind of depending on what your habits are. I struggle a little bit more because I'm just used to drinking more, I guess, when I'm sitting at my desk. Switch in the office, so I don't know, it's kind of been a struggle for me, but I found that if I drink through a straw, I drink so much more water. I drink it just so much quicker. So if you're struggling like me, maybe get some straws, just some cheap straws from any store that you can probably buy them at. Good, let's take a deep breath together. And that's been helping me. I think too, because I used to drink out of like squirt bottles and I drink quicker and faster out of those. And when I'm just drinking out of a regular cup, inhale, I don't drink as quickly. So that's probably why the straw helps a little bit. Whew, I hope you guys feel wonderful. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you're staying healthy, staying safe, staying strong, and we will be back together soon. And we are all in this together, and I'm here for you guys. Hope you're staying safe. Bye.